Computer. Computer is combination of hardware and software. Computer is combination of hardware and software. What is hardware? What is hardware? Hardware means we touch to feel. That all components is called hardware. Means we are touching hard disk, we are touching DVD writer. Means these are all the physical components. All physical components of computer is called hardware. And software means programs all are called software. Hardware means touch to feel. Means all physical components, touch to feel. I am touch this. This is a blackboard. I am feel. I am touching and feeling. Touch to feel means this is the blackboard and this is the physical. This is the one board. Means this is the one board. Here and the same also in computer. Touch to feel, all components is called hardware. And software is called, means programs, operating systems. These all are called software. Now, computer is combination of hardware and software. Hardware means touch to feel, all components is called hardware. And programs and operating systems, operating software, these all are called software. Now, types of computers. Types of computers. In this first one, supercomputer, and the second one is mainframe computer. Mainframe computer and third one is mini computer. And fourth one is micro. Friends, here computers mainly are dividing four types: supercomputer, mainframe computer, mini computer, and microcomputer. So here, first one, supercomputer. It is perform millions and trillions of mathematical operations per second. Now, the supercomputer speed we are calculating in flops. Flops means floating point operations per second. This supercomputer means what is the main feature of supercomputer? It is perform billions and trillions of mathematical calculations per second, and that calculation speed we are calculating in flops, floating point operations per second, supercomputer. So in this supercomputer, nowadays we are using Linux operating system, means the modified Linux operating system. And second one is the mainframe computer. And here, what is the difference between desktop computer and supercomputer? What is the difference between desktop computer and supercomputer? In desktop computer, we are using only one processor. But in supercomputer, in older days, they are using 100 processors. And Now they are using more than 30 lakh. 30 lakh. Process. Generally here I am saying 30 lakh code. Code nothing but one process. Means how to they are manufacturing supercomputer means in this supercomputer order is they are using more than 100 process. But present they are using above 30 lakh process. One core equal to one process. Means now we are using high speed supercomputers. In that supercomputer, hello. So in latest supercomputer, they are using more than 30 lakh cores. So that is the reason this computer is performed huge amount of calculations they are done in second. Next one is mainframe computer. Mainframe computer. In mainframe computer, what is the advantage of mainframe computer? In this one, it is multi-OS and multi-user computer. This is mainframe computer is multi-OS means we are installing many operating systems and we run many operating systems at a time in this mainframe computer. In mainframe computer we run at a time more than two or more multi operating systems at a time. We run multi operating systems at a time and same time it is supporting multi user capability. This is the advantage of mainframe computer. This mainframe computer is generally used in ATM card processing. Means when we are inserting ATM card in ATM center, immediately this total our country all ATM cards linked to one server. Means one mainframe computer. So this total ATM, for example SBI, this SBI main computer means main server locating Mumbai. All you are inserting card in all over India in any place, the total data means your information is sent to that server, Mumbai server. Immediately it is processing that how much balance in your account and how much you want to draw, and depending on that it is giving some instruction to your ATM local center. So means what is the difference between supercomputer and mainframe computer? Means supercomputer internal have huge amount of data, it is processing that, but mainframe computer it is taking huge amount of instructions from outside. Means mainframe computer is not taking at a time huge amount of instructions outside, but mainframe computer it is taking huge amount of instructions from outside and it is processing and it is giving output. That is the difference between supercomputer and mainframe computer. Supercomputer means first you give input, means you what is the data available in RAM, primary storage, it is processing that data and it is giving output in supercomputer. But mainframe computer, this mainframe computer is receiving data and instructions from outside and it is processing that and it is giving output. This is the difference between super computer and mainframe computer. Another one is the mini computer. Mini computer. So this mini computer, it is also multi-user computer, mini computer, and it is based with single operating system, and it is usually in small size offices, mini computer. Compared to this main computer, mainframe computer, it is very small computer, and it is also supporting multi-user, and it is used in small organizations, mini computer. And fourth one is micro computer. Micro computer. Actually, this micro computer is two types. First one is desktop computer, and another one is the laptop computer. Laptop computer. So micro computer is two types: desktop computer and laptop computer. Micro computer is allow single user and at a time single operating system. Microcomputer. It is very small computer compared to other computers. It is very small. It is used in personally, means at a time single user is using this microcomputer. This microcomputer two types. One is the desktop, another one is the laptop. Now we are discussing computer means computer is combination of hardware and software. Hardware means we know touch to feel, all physical components is called hardware. Software, next one is software. Actually, this software is two types. One is system software. And second one is application software. Application software. So in this first one, system software. What is the system software? Means it is interact with the client to machine. System software. Means the system software nothing but it is an operating system. This operating system is used to interact with the client to machine. System software. First one is system software. What is the use of system and software? Means if without operating system, this computer cannot do anything. So we communicate with that hardware to this user. That purpose we are using system software. System software means nothing but operating system. Operating system is called system software. It is used to interact with the computer to user. System software. Next one is application software. Application software. Application software means this software we are using for one specific task purpose. Means, you know, MS Office. MS Office. Means in this have many packages. MS Word, MS Paint, and spreadsheet. And next one means Photoshop. Next one is CorelDRAW. Means MS Office means here Paint and Word. Means which purpose we are using application software? Means application for software specially designed for one specific task. Means here Paint. We are using this software to draw one picture and we do paint that one. Next one is Word. We are composing one resume or other one. That purpose. Photoshop. We are editing photos. CorelDRAW. We are designing visiting cards and some letterheads. CorelDRAW. Means this application software specially designed for one specific task purpose. Means we are editing photos by using Photoshop software. We are creating our resume by using MS Word only. We draw simple pictures by using Microsoft Paint only. Means here every application software designed for one specific task purpose. Now, computer hardware. Computer hardware. So, computer hardware means we touch to feel. Means in this computer hardware means generally we are observing desktop computer, one monitor, and one keyboard. And one mouse. And here one CPU. These are all connecting to this CPU. This power button and this is DVD reader. This is means touch to feel. All physical components is called hardware. And in this is a monitor. Monitor is the output device. And keyboard, mouse, these two are the input devices. This is the CPU. Actual name is, it is ATX cabinet, but generally we are called CPU CPU. ATX cabinet, but generally we are called CPU. Today we are discussing this ATX cabinet internal parts. So now we are discussing means what is the ATX cabinet. Generally we are called CPU. CPU internal main parts. In CPU internal main parts, in this first one is power supply unit, and generally we are called SMPS. And second one is DVD writer. DVD writer. And third one is hard disk drive. And fourth one is RAM. And fifth one is processor. And sixth one is motherboard. Motherboard. In this RAM processor is on motherboard, but these are the individual. First one is the power supply unit. Next one is DVD. Next one is hard disk. Next RAM processor motherboard. These are the CPU internal parts. Means ATX cabinet internal parts. Now today we are discussing about SMPS. How to check SMPS? How much? How many voltage coming outside? We are discussing that. So first one is PSU, power supply unit, or SCPS. Actually, this SMPS is two types. So in this, first one is PAT, SMPS, and second one is ATX, SMPS. So first one is the AT SMPS. So first we are discussing about AT SMPS, advanced technology. AT means advanced technology. Technology SMPS. First one, AT SMPS. So in this SMPS have two connectors. One connector have 6 wires, another connector have 6 wires. 6 plus 6, 12 wire is available in AT SMPS. 12 wires. Means in AT SMPS have one connector have 6 wires, another connector have 6 wires. Total 12 wires is available, and this 12 wires is connecting to motherboard. And it is old technology, old SMPS. This SMPS is used in Pentium 1 and Pentium 2 and Pentium 3 computers. This is the old technology SMPS. Now we are not using. This SMPS is used in Pentium 1, Pentium 2, Pentium 3 processor based computers. This SMPS is used, and this SMPS have manual on off switch. It has manual on off switch. Means if you shut down OS, means when you are shut down your computer, that time also this SMPS is working. That is the drawback in this one. When you are switch off switch, manual switch, that time only SMPS is off condition. Means here, this advanced technology, means this AT SMPS is old technology SMPS. It have two connectors, 6 plus 6, two connectors, means total 12 wires. And this SMPS is used Pentium 1, Pentium 2, Pentium 3 processor based computers only. And it have manual switch. This is an old technology SMPS. Next one is ATX. ATX SMPS. Switch mode power supply. SMPS means switch mode power supply. It is a one type of technology, switching technology. ATX means advanced technology extended. Advanced technology extended. Extended SMPS. ATX. It have 20 or 24 pin connector for motherboard, and another one is 4 pin connector for processor. And it also have rail. That rail we are using for connecting DVD writers, hard disk. That purpose we are using rail. Means here another one is it have soft on-off switch. Soft power on-off switch. Soft power on-off switch. Means what is the difference between AT and ATX? Means here in this ATX system just have soft power on off switch. Means when you are shut down your OS, immediately SMP is standby mode, means off condition. This is the main advantage of in ATX, and this ATX have 20 or 24 pin connector, means 20 or 24 wires for motherboard purpose, and it have 4 pin connectors for processor. Means here we are providing individual voltage to processor section, but that purpose here we are using 4 pin connector, and DVD reader purpose, hard disk purpose, we are using another rail. That rail have many connectors. Start of power connector, or if we are using old one, the time we have Molex connectors. Means that rail have Molex connectors and start of power connectors. Now, what are the main voltages of this ATX system? ATX systems have main voltages. Here, first one, 3.3 volts DC, and next one is here 5 volts, and next one is 12 volts. These are the main voltages of this ATX system. What are that? One is the 3.3 volts, and 5 volts, and 12 volts. These three are the main voltages for our this ATX system, yes, main voltages. And here this 3.3 voltage is providing orange cables. Orange cables, and 5 volts is providing red cables, and 12 volts is providing yellow cables. And here green turn, power on, green wire, green cable, and power good. Power and power okay. Means here power on green wire, and here power good and power okay. This purpose here we are using another one is standby. Standby purpose violet, and on the customer journey, depending on the messages and while and power okay and power good. This purpose here we are using green and another one is purple. Means here only these three is the main voltages and another one is the power on green cable. This is the main voltages and how to switch on this system here. Switch on purpose here we are using green wire. Without motherboard, how to check this SMPS? So that time you connect one jumper from this green cable, this green wire to black wire. Immediately your SMPS scan is rotating. If SMPS scan is rotating means here that SMPS is okay. If SMPS scan is not rotating means problem in SMPS. These are the main voltages. One is the 3.3 volts, another one is the 5 volts, another one is the 12 volts. These are the main voltages. Now, how to check SMPS without motherboard? If we have motherboard, simply we are connecting SMPS to motherboard and we try to switch on that motherboard. That time if SMPS is working, that time motherboard means the power supply is rotating and power LED is on. But without motherboard, how to check means connect jumper from green by to block by. Means here we have one SMPS. This is the 24 pin connector. Means some motherboard supporting only 20 pin connector. So that time you remove or you detach this 4 pin connector. Some motherboards is supporting only 20 means some motherboard supporting 24 pin connector. That time you attach this. Now it is 24 pin connector. And if your motherboard not supporting 24 pin connector, that time you detach this. And here you see here in this is a green wire. This is for power on off switch purpose. And here another one is here you see. Orange. This orange cables is providing 3.3 volts. And this red cable is providing 5 volts. And this yellow cable is providing 12 volts. And here also, this is a rail. This rail have, here, this rail have, one is the Molex connector, another one is the SATA connector. This is a Molex connector. And this is the SATA connector. This is Molex connector, this one, and this is a SATA connector. This is rail and this is another rail. You are using these rails for connecting DVD writers and hard disks. This is the SMPS internal ports here and this is SMPS fan. Now how do we check this SMPS without motherboard? So now we connect one power cable. And here we connect one jumper, means one copper wire or aluminum wire. You connect this green wire to any black wire. So here I am connecting one jumper green to any block. Here I have many black wires. I am connecting jumper green to black wire. After I am providing power supply. Now here you observe that fan is rotating. Now again I am switched off. Means when fan is rotating means your SMPS is working condition. Or you observe from this side. Now fan is rotating. Means your SMPS is okay. Now we check this SMPS voltages. Means here sometimes fan is rotating, but then you are connecting this SMPS to motherboard. That time motherboard is not working, or sometimes processor fan is rotating, but no display problem is coming. So that time where is the problem? Means here in this SMPS it is called a primary section. From here to this section is called primary section. And here to this section is called secondary section. In secondary section side, here you see these all are the filter capacitors. Sometimes if this capacitor is bulging, or sometimes this capacitor is weak, that time it is showing voltage 12 volts, but that 12 volt is not pure DC voltage because here capacitors is damaging or capacitor is weak. So if capacitor is weak means it is not filtering that voltage properly. Means here your motherboard is receiving impure DC voltage. So in impure DC voltage your motherboard is not working properly. So that is the reason fan is rotating. But when we are connecting your this SMPS to your motherboard, that time motherboard is not working. Actually here I am providing power supply here, and this is a SMPS fan, but this SMPS fan has some problem. That is the reason it is generating some noise. And here you see if SMPS is working, that time this fan is rotating. Or you observe from this side. But sometimes SMPS fan is rotating, but when you are connecting this SMPS to your motherboard, that time your motherboard is not working. But you are connecting another SMPS to your motherboard, SMPS, but that time motherboard is working properly. Means here SMPS fan is rotating, but if I am connecting this SMPS to motherboard, motherboard is not working. I am connecting another SMPS to same motherboard, motherboard is working. So that time you suspect this secondary section capacitor. These are the DC capacitors. Means here it is filter output voltage. If this capacitor is bulged or weak, that time it is not filter that DC voltage. So that time we are getting impure DC voltage, means DC voltage with some ripple. But motherboard only working in pure DC voltage only. If DC voltage with ripple, that time motherboard is not working properly. So that time you replace this capacitors, that time your motherboard is working properly. This is the one problem. Actually, in this system, just main damageable parts is in primary section, main capacitors. First, second, this switching transistors. Third one, bridge rectifier. And common component is fuse. Means in this, if switching transistors is short or diodes is short, that immediately fuse is blow off. Means in this major problem, means SMPS capacitor, means output side. In SMPS secondary section side, capacitors bulge or weak. This is the first problem. Second is this side, switching transistors is short, or this bridge rectifier is short, or sometimes these capacitors are also bulging. So that time you check and replace these components, that time the SMPS is working properly. Means here you remember, if you are connecting jumper from block to green, fan is rotating, means SMPS is okay. But if it is giving pure voltage or not, how we know? Means we are not doing in all places, customer places, we are not doing oscilloscope. So that is the reason, if you are suspecting, that time you connect another SMPS and check once again. This is the SMPS. Now we are checking this SMPS output voltage. Here I am checking, I am selecting DC voltage and keep one block probe. In block wire means negative. Now I am checking main voltage here. Means here it is showing 12 volts. Means it is yellow color wire. Next red color wire. How much? 5.2. It means 5 volts. Next orange wire. Orange wire. How much showing it is? 3.3 volts. Orange is 3.3 volts, and here red is 5 volts, and here yellow is 12 volts. This is the output voltage. If it is showing this voltage properly, means SMPS is okay. And next topic is DVD writer. So before that, we are discussing about this storage devices. So first one is, we are discussing about storage devices. Data storage devices. data storage device. And this first one is optical storage device. Magnetic storage device. First one is the optical, second one is the magnetic, another one is the semiconductor storage device. Means here optical data storage device, magnetic data storage device, semiconductor data storage device. Means optical storage device means it is not storing optical, it is store data. Here we are already mentioned here data storage devices. In this one is a optical data storage device, second one is magnetic data storage device, and another one is a semiconductor data, semiconductor based data storage device. So first we are discussing optically data storage device. Optically data storage device is this first one, CD writer. CD writer. And second one is CD writer. And third one is DVD combo. And the fourth one is DVD writer. DVD writer. And fifth one is Blu-ray writer. Blu-ray writer. Means optical data storage device means here in this CD drive we are using CD compact disc. In DVD drive combo, in DVD writer, here we are using DVD disc, digital versatile disc, and Blu-ray. In this we are using Blu-ray disc. Now we are discussing about that. Means optical data storage device means this device is store data optically on disk. Why we are saying optical data storage device means it is store data optically on disk. So in these devices, optical data storage device, what are the devices? Means CD, means CD drive, CD writer, DVD combo, DVD writer, and Blu-ray writer. These are the devices. In these devices, we are using disks. So, on the disk, we are store data optically on the disk. So, first, CD, compact disk. So, this disk capacity is 700 MB. Means we are store up to 700 MB data. Next one is DVD, digital versatile disc. DVD think of it, digital versatile disc. This DVD is two types. First one, single layer. It is stored up to 4.7 GB. and second one double layer. Double layer means it is stored up to 8 GB. Double layer or dual layer. Next one is Blu-ray. Blu-ray, this Blu-ray disc, this Blu-ray disc, it is in this single layer store up to 40 GB, and another one is dual layer, double layer. It is stored up to 120 GB. Present, this two is available, but recently Panasonic company and Sony company, they are introducing new technology. By using that new technology, same size disk, on that disk we store up to 300 GB data. New technology, but till now it is on market not coming. It is now under in trial, in lab experiment. 300 GB new technology in this Blu-ray disk. Now this Sony and Panasonic is introducing new technology. By using that new technology, we store up to 300 GB data on one single disk. Here CD, DVD, Blu-ray disk, these all are the same size, but in CD store only 700 MB. DVD are two types, single layer DVD store up to 4.7 GB, and double layer it is store 8 GB. And Blu-ray disk, in this Blu-ray disk also two types, single layer and double layer. So single layer is store up to 40 GB data, and double layer present it is store up to 120 GB. But recently this Panasonic and Sony company, they are introducing new technology. By using that new technology, we store up to 300 GB data. These are the optical storage device disks. Means this optical storage device is store data optically on this disk. CD, compact disk, digital version satellite disk, and Blu-ray disk. These are the optical storage devices. And as per our syllabus, how to rectify small problems in disk drive devices, optical storage devices, means CD writer or DVD writer. If in this any problem, means small problems, means sometimes tray is not opening properly, not closing properly. Sometimes opening also difficult, closing also difficult. And sometimes disk is not reading properly, it is taking more time. So this small problems, how do you rectify? So today we are discussing about main parts of this DVD writer, internal, and we observe practically in next class. What are the internal problems? What are the internal parts? And what are the small problems? How to rectify that problems? We are discussing in next class. So in this, first one is in this. For example, DVD writer. In this DVD writer, main parts. Main parts. Means it is in our syllabus. In our syllabus, how to rectify small issues in DVD writer. So in this, main parts is first one. Is DVD writer. Second one is and belt. And third one is spindle motor. And fourth one is pickup motor. Pickup motor. Fifth one is lens unit. Lens unit. And sixth one is motherboard. These are the main parts of in DVD writer. First one is the DVD tray, and the tray is operating with one motor and belt. Next is spindle motor. This spindle motor is used to rotate the disc. Next, pickup motor. This pickup motor is used to move that lens unit. And next one is the lens unit. Means this lens unit is generating laser beam, and that beam is projecting on disc. After that reflected beam is receiving again this lens unit. In this lens unit have some sensors. That sensor is detecting that reflected light and it is converted to digital form. Already we are discussing this total topic in our regular class. And next one is motherboard. Means every hard disk DVD writer downside, I mean that disk, the drive downside have one board. That board is called the drive motherboard. In motherboard have here spindle motor driver IC and RAM and processor. These are the main parts of motherboard. In this motherboard, main components is, first one is motor driver IC. Motor driver IC. Next one is RAM. And second one is the processor. These are the main parts of the motherboard. Means every DVD writer have one motherboard. Our motherboard have main parts is motor driver IC, RAM, generally we are called profile RAM, and another one is the processor. These are the main parts of in motherboard, and these are the main parts. In next class, we are open the DVD writer and we are observing what are the internal parts, what are the basic problems is coming. For example, if tray not opening properly, not closing properly, what is the problem? Means here, this tray is operating with this motor and belt. If this belt is loose, that time it is not opening properly tray and not closing the tray properly. Problem in belt. Sometimes this tray is moving on mechanism, freely moving purpose, here we are using grease. If this grease is dry, that time also this tray is not opening properly, not closing properly. So before we are replacing these components, first we are checking all these things. First we are checking belt is good condition or not. Belt is good condition, but tray is not opening, not closing properly. That is again we are check that tray grease. If grease is dry, that time we are removing that grease by using tissue paper and we are applying new grease. Grease means don't think this is not a Castrol or Elf grease. This is different grease. Means plastic mechanism purpose, they are manufacturing special grease. You go and ask in electron shops, I want plastic mechanism grease. They are giving one small tube. It is look like one small ointment tube type. It is only specially for plastic mechanism purpose. If you are using normal grease, again the grease is dry. After 1 month or 2 months, again it is creating problem. Normal grease only designed for bearings, ball bearings or bearings and bushes purpose. That grease is not suitable for this plastic mechanism purpose. This plastic mechanism purpose, they manufacture special grease. It is available in electronic shops. And the one is the spindle motor. Sometimes this spindle motor is not rotating. So that time problem in spindle motor or this spindle motor driver IC. Where is the problem? And sometimes this pickup motor is not rotating. Means here also we are using grease for trail moving purpose. If the grease is dry, that time also it is creating some friction. That time this motor is not rotating, means lens unit is not rotating. Sometimes it is means if we are inserting disc, 10 to 15 minutes we are watching movie properly. After 15 minutes, movie is hanging. Means after 15 minutes, after 30 minutes, we are not seeing next movie. But the disc is new disc, no scratches. If you insert another disc also, same after 30 minutes or 35 minutes, same problem is coming. Where is the problem? Means problem in this pickup unit. And next one is lens unit. So this lens unit, in this lens unit have laser diode, it is generating laser beam. Another one is the reflector lasers. Another one is the sensors. And one is the focusing lens. So these are the main parts of in this lens unit. And next one is the motherboard. This motherboard is receiving 5 volts and 12 volts from SLPS. And on motherboard have one processor, one RAM, and one driver IC. These are the main parts in next class that we are observing practically on DVD writer. What are the internal parts? How to be rectify that problems practically? Now, question.